It is almost, in fact, when she has her driver's license and we go places, they're like, this isn't you. Because it was her old former self when she weighed 200 pounds and...
Oh yeah, it did.
Yeah.
It did. Oh yes, I remember
yeah.
Now. You just like, I'm tired of being...
In my
fat
suit?
Yeah.
In your fat suit, right?
I was in my fat suit. Yeah, I was unhappy, depressed, and alcoholic, and decided to change my will and my life over to the care of my higher power, and here I am.
I like it. It suits you well.
Thank you. Feels good too.
I know.
Are you an alcoholic?
Me? Yes.
Were you at one point?
Situational
alcoholic. I'm a functional, and whenever I want alcohol,
I'm a situational.
Speaking of which.
Why do you drink? Tell me.
It's fun. It's social, and I like it. And I like the buzz. Here's my problem in drinking. This is personally. I didn't drink at all coming up. Like, you know, I was the good Mormon girl, didn't do anything. So then once I figured out I could drink, I was like, holy shit, I love this. You know, you're like, oh my God, this is so fun. But then I never did it. And then, honestly, I started just drinking more and more and more, and it actually relaxed me. It was actually a way I could go to sleep. It made things a lot easier for me. And I have a shit ton of kids, and they stress me the F out. And this is before I smoked weed. So now that I smoke weed, I don't drink that much anymore. But when I drink, man, I start to drink and it's fun. I'm more fun when I drink wine than when I drink hard liquor, because hard liquor, it's too hard, you know? Wine is kind of like the Latin in me comes out. I'm like, da-da-da-da, let's have fun, and it's great, and it's party time. I start drinking alcohol and people, or liquor, and people are like, whoa, man, she's scared.
Right. So, very different story. I started drinking at like 13 with my father and my siblings, and then I just never stopped.
Oh, God. So it's kind of conditioning, pretty much, programming.
You can see my rear. I haven't seen your rear yet.
Get the pictures D just took.
I know.
And zhuzh them up.
That's what he wants, because I said I need to work on my rear.
Zhuzh them.
And I just sent you two more donations.
You need to work on your.
She said, tell me you need to work on your typing.
It's horrible.
I love her. No, that's the thing. That's what you want.
Okay.
I haven't looked at my face pretty much all day long.
I need glasses.
Do mine work for you? I think we tried this the other night. Those are cute. Look how cute she looks in those. Do you like how
they? Don't look at
me. I like the one.
Figured out I was different, and I didn't want that life.
What, the military life?
I liked the military life. I was a military brat, and I know what the aspects were and everything. I just didn't want to be. I love him enough to like be okay with that. Yeah. It's not whether you want it or not. It's whether you're willing to go the extra mile to like do what they like, and you have to like somebody a lot for that. And I actually do. For that.
I can understand that. I do. There's a lot of things I've done in my marriage. I'm like, I wouldn't set out like, oh, I choose that. I choose that straight out the gate. But then, like, I love this person. This is something that, it's like a compromise. Really, when you're in a relationship with someone, it's a compromise
it's
of sorts, no?
It's how far you're willing to go for the other person.
Exactly.
And how what you're willing to, like, take for the other person.
Well, yeah. It's like it's a give and take. It's not just all one person giving or all one person taking. It's the compromise that makes it so beautiful.
Right.
Mia, let me help you do a pair of their shoe.
So how far will you go for love?
Well, that's a
very
loaded
far.
Question. How far have I gone? Got me drinking on a Monday at 3. I don't know. Just kidding. That's love, baby.